all right. Your father's very amusing.
Thank you.
And your mother is very patient.
Oh, you have no idea.
Now, this bearskin rug of mine is very valuable. When might I expect him to return it?
That's the thing, Edward. He's going to be buried in it.
This guy here, he's not even dead.
Oh, he will be by, what do you say, George, Saturday?
I'm hoping Friday. I don't want to ruin your weekend.
I'm confused here. What the hell's wrong with the casket?
Oh, I have had it with politicians. Perhaps I could find a prominent businessman to speak at my function.
I'd be happy to do it.
Yes, well, let's not panic just yet. Dharma, who is your friend?
You are kidding.
Dharma.
Oh, this is George.
He wants to die in my rug.
Okay. Hand it over.
Greg, what are you doing here?
Dharma, on your way over when you stopped at the bank, Mr. Little Fox here
went
into...
me?
No, no, of course not. I called a friend of mine at the FBI.
Me followed by the FBI?
Because that's who I know who follows people. Dharma, he went into a knife store.
Yeah, I know, Greg. He was getting the handle on his hunting knife fixed. You want to give it to you as a present for letting him stay in our house.
I'm so sorry about this, George.
That's all right. Your husband really loved you.
Oh, you're right. He loves me so much, he should trust me.
Dharma.
No, don't even start, Greg. First you have me followed, and then you just rush on in here like a big old macho cowboy.
Don't say cowboy in front of the Indian.
That's okay, I'm a big Dallas fan.